Now, journalists, MPs and whistleblowers face possible jail time in an increasingly bitter battle over press freedom in Australia. The government has distanced itself from twin federal police raids on journalists in Sydney and Canberra, with calls for the laws covering what can be published or broadcast in this country to be changed. Joining me now from Arana Hills in Queensland is the government's Peter Dutton and Labor's Anthony Albanese in the studio with us now. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Peter Dutton, it's claimed that journalism is being criminalised in Australia. Are you comfortable with the prospect of journalists and whistleblowers ending up behind bars?
Well, Deb, if we strip it down, we're talking about highly classified documents. Now, the laws that apply today are the same laws that apply under the Shorten government or the Rudd government or the Howard government in relation to the leaking of documents. And if you're talking about highly classified, top secret documents, an argument that Albo or I could leak those documents and that there would be no penalty, or that a journalist could have possession of those documents, that might be against our national interest to publish them, that there should be no penalty or consequence for that, would go against tradition in our country that spans back many, many decades, and the same case in other democracies around the world.
OK, but protecting national security is one thing, but shining a light on possible war crimes by our soldiers in Afghanistan, or reporting on a push for new powers to spy on Australians, which is what these two reports that are at the centre of the raids were revealing, how is that a risk to national security?
Well, Deb, if you have a look at the referral, the referral's been made by the Secretary of the Defence Department and the Director-General of the Australian Signals Directorate, as I understand it. They've made the referral to the Australian Federal Police. The Federal Police have an obligation to investigate that matter if it's been referred to them. And they've got equally an obligation under law to conduct their inquiries independently. Nobody would accept me as Minister or Albo as Minister directing how an investigation should take place or who should be raided or who should be subject to inquiry. We have laws that operate in this country, and the Federal Police, who have been criticised by people, including Albo, which I think has been quite unfair to target those officers individually.
I
think that is
you,
quite
buddy.
Wrong.
I'm targeting and you. You're
no,
the government.
No, mate, I heard,
you're the
I heard,
government.
I heard your words.
You're the government.
I heard your words. You're criticising the individual
the
police officers. I think even the
That's not true.
Even the police union has been horrified
are,
at the words you said.
I don't even know
well,
who they
mate,
are. I'm under you. You're
you
the government.
You said you were horrified by
you're,
their actions.
You're the government. You're the government. And it is outrageous.
Stand by your words,
I have said it is outrageous. The anarchist Smethurst house was raided by seven police for 7.5 hours. That's an outrage.
Well, you're criticising the police, Albo. That is
no,
an investigation.
No,
they
I'm
make
not.
A decision.
I am criticising the
wrong.
Government, and I am calling for the government to explain exactly what it knew about these circumstances. Let's strip it back here. Do the public have a right to know if it is being considered that the government to government, two departments, are engaged in a debate to increase spying powers against Australian citizens? Is that in the public interest? Now, the media have a role in a democracy. And what we're seeing here is no one in the government being prepared to defend the role that media has in our democracy, which is essential.
Well,
defend.
You know that that's not true, mate.
Well, Albo,
well,
you
know that's
not true. Labor helped pass
all of us
their
defend,
laws
all of us
as they stand.
Media's rights.
No, actually, the laws. Anyway, we have had briefings that that's not right in terms of Peter is right that these are old laws that have been in place for a very long period of time. Peter is right.
So do you want
it
the laws
also,
as they stand it, to be changed?
It is also correct that what we need to do is to have a mature debate about what the role of the media is in our society and their capacity to actually provide appropriate scrutiny of government and of opposition.
Well, Peter Dutton, if we can all agree that a strong media is good for democracy and should be protected, will the government review the laws as they stand? Because in countries like the US, journalists have protections for whistleblowers enshrined in law. Should that be the case here?
Well, Deb, we do have protections enshrined in law, and we value a very healthy Fourth Estate. There's no question of that.
But
and
are you concerned that
the
journalists could be facing jail time?
I'm concerned that if people are leaking top secret documents, that that can affect our national security. Now, nobody's saying that there shouldn't be a debate about what a government is or isn't proposing. That there was no proposal, incidentally, in relation to this extra powers. That's the way it was wrongly reported, but that's a separate issue. But in relation to the media scrutiny or somebody having a say about what a government was proposing to do or legislation that had been put forward, that's the appropriate time for there to be scrutiny around whatever the proposal might be. But the leaking or publishing of top secret documents, which have been classified either by the Defence Department or by the Australian Signals Directorate, there are good reasons and long-standing reasons why a country like us or the United Kingdom or New Zealand would classify documents in such a way. And the point is that the Federal Police have an obligation to investigate a matter that has been referred to them. They have an obligation under law to do it independently, not with the direction of the government directing who should be investigated, etc. That would be an absurd proposition. Mm. And therefore, the criticism that Elba and others has levelled against the individual officers has just been completely unjust.
I don't even know who the officers are, Peter. So the idea that individual officers...
Go to your own words.
Which individual officers have I criticised?
The ones that attended the raid.
The ones who attended the raid. Who were they?
The seven officers. Your own
Seriously.
Words, Albo.
All right.
Well, I can't correct the record for you.
You are trying to distract from the real issue here. The real issue here
is that
Australians are concerned that media's capacity to scrutinise government is under threat. Mm. That's the concern that Australians have. It's a simple one. It's one which you, as part of a government, you consistently have been trying to avoid scrutiny in all of the portfolios you've had. So I'm not surprised that's your approach.
Mate, you're joking, aren't you? This is just apologise, mate, and move on. That would be the good thing for you today.
I won't be apologising to you, Peter Dutton,
because you characterise the sort of secrecy... And
lack of scrutiny that embodies your entire political career. You stand up consistently and say...
You're digging deeper, mate.
All right, we are unfortunately
out of time. Just apologise.
Apologise for what? What should he be apologising for?
For attacking the police officers involved. Attack the government, that's fine. That's his job.
I'm on to you.
All right. Gentlemen, we thank you for your time this morning. Unfortunately, time is against it. Lots of other issues to discuss, but we look forward to having you back on the programme